I got a number of requests about how to identify the Pterygopalatine fossa. So in this video, I'll quickly give you an idea of how to locate the Pterygopalatine fossa. Okay, so what you see here is the temporal fossa. This is the lateral view of the skull, and this region is the temporal fossa, which is usually in life or in an undissected specimen and a cadaver, you will see the temporalis muscle filling the temporal fossa. Okay, now from the temporal fossa, if you put a probe like this underneath the zygomatic arch, the tip of the probe is going to reach here. Okay, you should understand that this is going medial to the zygomatic arch. Then that region, the point where the tip of the arrow is now located, is called the infratemporal fossa. And as the name indicates, it is below the temporal fossa. I'm going to zoom in, okay, into the infratemporal fossa. Okay, into the infratemporal fossa. Now I am in the infratemporal fossa. This bone that you see is the coronoid process of the mandible. Okay, I'm going a little more deeper, and you can see now I am in the infratemporal fossa, right? Because I've just zoomed in. Now from the infratemporal fossa, if I'm looking medially, I am seeing this a bony crevice, okay, and this is called the Terrigo maxillary fissure. Now let me make this point very clear. This is the posterior aspect of the maxilla, so slightly bulged body of the maxilla, and this is the anterior part of the pterygoid process, which contains the lateral pterygoid plate. You are actually viewing the lateral surface of the lateral pterygoid plate. You also have the medial pterygoid plate on the other side. But this is the pterygoid process and the pterygoid plates. You can see that lower down they are somewhat meeting with each other, but upper part they are diverging from each other. So this triangular gateway is called the pterygomaxillary fissure. Okay, fissure. And if we go through the pterygomaxillary fissure medially, so I'm using this arrow to show that I'm going inside the pterygomaxillary fissure, then I'll reach a cavity, a small cavity. This cavity is pyramidal in shape, with a base located above and the apex that is directed below, right? It is a pyramidal space, and that pyramidal space is called as the pterygopalatine fossa. You know that this is pterygoid plate and this is the maxilla, but when we go to the space, it is called pterygopalatine fossa, because this bone that you see here is the perpendicular plate of the palatine. Let me make that point clear by just removing the zygomatic, the mandible and the maxilla from this model. Okay, so the maxilla is removed, and now you are seeing the perpendicular plate of the palatine bone. Okay, this is the horizontal plate of the palatine bone. Okay, and this is the perpendicular plate of the palatine bone. So this cavity is now more clear. When we removed the maxilla, it is more clear, and this space is called the pterygopalatine fossa. If you have seen one of my previous videos where I have described the foramina at the base of skull, I have told one foramen is directing from the middle cranial fossa towards the pterygopalatine fossa. Which was that? That was the foramen rotundum, which allowed the passage of the maxillary nerve. So let us look at whether that foramen rotundum is seen. Yes, this is the foramen rotundum. Foramen rotundum is communicating the pterygopalatine fossa here to the middle cranial fossa. Let me just rotate this to ensure that this is the foramen rotundum. So foramen rotundum allows the passage of maxillary nerve right into the pterygopalatine fossa. Okay, pterygopalatine fossa is somewhat at the junction, one of the crossroad positions of the head and neck anatomy, where a lot of neurovascular structures will meet and they will diverge or branch and so on and so forth. So over here you have a very important ganglion, and that ganglion is called the pterygopalatine ganglion. An older term for this was the sphenopalatine ganglion, but now the terminology is pterygopalatine ganglion. Pterygopalatine ganglion is topographically, that means location of the pterygopalatine ganglion is related to the maxillary nerve. And now you know Yeah, now you clearly know that the maxillary nerve was coming out of the foramen rotundum, and from the maxillary nerve you have these two twigs which will reach the pterygopalatine ganglion. The pterygopalatine ganglion is functionally related to the facial nerve. Okay, the greater petrosal nerve gives off a vidian nerve. That vidian nerve will finally reach into the pterygopalatine ganglion. It is basically a parasympathetic ganglion that is going to innervate the lacrimal gland as well as the glands of the nasal, the palatine. All those glands are all innervated by the pterygopalatine ganglion. But now you know how this is topographically related to the maxillary nerve. Okay, so that is about a rough idea about where the pterygopalatine ganglion is. More details about the connections of the pterygopalatine ganglion will be taken in the next videos. Okay, so I'm going back to this view to again revise how to see the pterygopalatine fossa. This is the temporal fossa. Go down, you reach the infratemporal fossa. Go medially, you reach the pterygopalatine fossa, which is guarded by this gate, that is the pterygo maxillary fissure. Pterygo maxillary fissure is a gate between the infratemporal fossa and the pterygopalatine fossa. I hope the point is clear. Thank you so much.